Trail Ridge Grizzlies. This is Miss Scannell here. I've met most of you by now, but if you haven't met me, my classroom's on the first floor and I teach both reading and math this year. So I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about Chautauqua. You guys are all going to be there in just a day or two. And I wanted to show you some of the things I like to bring when I go to Chautauqua. It's one of my favorite places. I hike there a lot. I run there. In the winter, I go snowshoeing. So it's one of my favorite places, and I'm really excited you guys are going to get to go. So today, I'm up early for a trail run. It's about 6 in the morning. And I packed all my stuff last night so that I didn't have to worry about it this morning. I knew I was getting up early. You guys should try to do the same thing. You get up early for school. Sometimes you're busy, you're in a rush. You might forget some really important things that will make your trip a lot more enjoyable. So let me show you a few of the things I packed. This is my backpack that I take running with me. If you have one of those little string backpacks, those are great for short hikes that we're going to be doing. School backpack is fine, perfect too. Any of those will work just fine. You just need something to put all your stuff in. So we have a backpack. I have water in here. Mine is in a Camelback. But for you guys, Nalgene is perfect, Dasani, bottle, anything from the vending machine, but you need water. So any kind of water bottle is perfect. But bring water. It gets hot, it's dry in Colorado. Just by being out there and breathing the air, you can get dehydrated. So you'll have a lot more fun if you drink lots of water. You can refill this at the ranger station. Okay, so we have water. You also need to make sure you have closed-toe shoes. I'll show you. These are the ones I'm going to wear. Just tennis shoes. Perfect. Flip-flops, ballet flats, Toms, anything like that are not going to be comfortable for this kind of a hike. So tennis shoes are great. Anything else, you can really get kind of blisters and make your feet hurt, and we're going to be on our feet a lot. So make sure you have good shoes so that you have a good trip. Okay, so we've got water, we've got closed-toe shoes, we've got a backpack. You want to bring some kind of a warm layer. So I usually bring a little windbreaker in my backpack. It's lightweight, doesn't really affect me much, but I always have it in case the clouds come over the sun. That can make it feel a lot colder, especially in the mountains. Or if we get a little rain shower or something, I know I have a layer to stay warm. It can also be kind of breezy in the mountains, so that can make you feel a lot colder. So even if you get up, you look at the weather forecast, it's supposed to be 90 degrees. Make sure you have something like this. A hoodie is great, sweatshirt, anything like that just to kind of cover up. T-shirt is great. T-shirt with the hoodie, perfect layering for the mountains. Okay, it's going to probably be sunny when we're there. Pretty high chance of that, so you want to have some sunscreen. I put mine on before I go running. Here's my kitty. you can bring it with you, just put a little on, protect you from the sun. Important, burns are not fun. This is the hat I usually run in. I'm not going to wear it today because I'm going to be there so early. The sun isn't going to be very strong. But you guys don't get to wear hats in school, right? This is a good day to bring a hat. And you're allowed to wear it. It'll keep the sun out of your eyes, off your head. Good stuff. Okay, I'm wearing sunglasses today. Sunglasses are good to have as well. So your choice, optional, but I suggest taking at least one or the other. Sometimes I take both. Okay, so we've got hat, water, sunscreen, backpack, warm layer, closed-toe shoes, food. You guys need food, right? So bring a lunch, bring a sack lunch if you really need a lunch from the cafeteria. Make sure you've talked to a teacher. Make sure you've marked it on your permission slip. Really important to have food. Bring some snacks, too, if you can. Granola bars are great. Fruit is great. Try to bring something healthy. If you only eat Takis and kind of junky food like that, it's not going to fill you up and fuel your body for the whole day. So try to bring something healthy to eat. Okay? All right. Last but not least, I'm going to introduce you to my dog, Bella. She's going to come running with me today, and she's going to help me introduce Chautauqua to you. So we're going to head out, and we'll see you guys in Chautauqua.
Seventh graders, here I am in Chautauqua.
Beautiful, these are the Flatirons right here.
Boulder's famous for the Flatirons. Here's the, now you can't really see with the sun glare, but this is where you guys are gonna come in. So I'm here with Bella. We're gonna head up the Mesa Trail, which actually goes up this way. And I don't know what trails you guys are gonna be able to hike on. The Mesa Trail is a great one. It's not too steep. Pretty much anywhere in Chautauqua that you go, you're gonna be headed uphill first. So you kind of have to have that growth mindset that I can make it up the hill and have a new experience. Or if you've been here before, maybe you'll see something that you've never seen before, or you'll go on a trail you've never been on. Every time I come here, I see something new, even though I've been here a lot of times. So we're gonna head up the Mesa Trail. Bella's gonna carry this GoPro here, so you guys will be able to see where we're going. A couple notes. Bella, you're gonna see, will go off the trail. She's a dog. In a minute here, I'm gonna let her off this leash, and she's gonna kinda go where she wants. She'll hang out with me. When you guys come here, though, you want to try to make sure you stay on the trails. Thousands of people come here every day, and if everyone went off the trail, then there would be no more beautiful grass for everyone. So make sure when you guys come that you stay on the trail. Bella's pretty small, and her 4 feet, little tiny feet, won't do much damage, but our big human feet will. So stay on the trail. You want to practice leave no trace principles. So if you have trash, take it with you. Put it in your backpack. I take all my wrappers with me. I even have to clean up after Bella and take anything, any of her waste with me in my backpack. Yes, it's true. Okay, so I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to switch to the GoPro and show you guys some of the trails.
The reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful. Clearing the sea out, see the bedwind fires at night, see the oil fields at first light, and see the bird with the leaf in her mouth. After the flood, all the colors came out. It was a beautiful.